Hello, welcome to my creating room. I'm so excited to show you today's image that we're going to deconstruct. This whole series is about deconstructing Photoshop files that I have created. I'm primarily a fine art photographer, and in doing so, I have tons and tons and tons of creative images that I've spent hours and hours making in Photoshop, and I want to show you how they were made because, first of all, secrets are no fun. So let's share. And second of all, it feels really nice to bring someone into my creative space because I work entirely alone. Being a self-portrait artist, I'm always by myself. I don't have an assistant or anything like that. So this is where I am, by myself all the time. But now you're here and it makes me so happy. So let's dive into Photoshop. We've got a fun image today of an explosion, and I thought that this would be really entertaining to take a look at because it's just weird and messy and fun. So let's do it. So let's go down to the beginning of the layers and we'll see how this image started. So here we have me jumping in a field, clearly with the dirty lens because I have a spot on my camera. And let's just see how this explosion happened, because clearly to go from this to this, lots of different pictures had to go in here. All right, so I added hair on, which seems really unnecessary when you think about the final image, but I did it. Created a little fog layer that's just a little bit of a light brush painting over the background, and expanded the frame. And then I added in smoke. So this smoke was from a smoke emitter that I set off on a backdrop, and I added that in so that there would be this sense of upward motion of smoke. And then I started adding in little tiny elements. So these are little flowers that I had photographed that were dead, and I thought that would be a nice little addition. Some baby powder, flour, so many things went into this. Not flowers, flour, like for cooking. More smoke, fog. Now this is the flour, so you can see like the little particles. Let's zoom in here. You can see the little particles happening, and that's because it was heavier flour with motion blur on it, which was great for this image because having motion blur, that upward motion, really gave that explosive look. I think that if there wasn't motion blur, we'd have a problem. So there's some more of that flour, and I really wanted to make sure, like, you know, when you get to this point, it looks okay, right? Like, it's blending. This was a particularly helpful stage, but I wanted to make sure that it was thicker at the chest and then thinner moving out, so that it was really realistic that the explosion was starting here. So we've got more smoke coming in, because I thought that there was something missing from here, like it was too tidy. So I added a little bit of smoke coming out. And now I'm darkening it, so now I'm playing. So if you want to create your own sort of explosion picture, I mean, find whatever you can to photograph. Make sure you photograph that thing on a background that contrasts. So let's say the only thing that you can find is salt. You've got a lot of salt and you can use salt. Make sure that you get a black backdrop for it so that when you throw the salt, it really stands out against the backdrop. And vice versa, if you have something dark like dirt that you're going to use, use a light backdrop. That would have been amazing for this image to use like an explosion of dirt. That would have been so good. Oh, I wish I had done it. But anyway, whatever you do, opposite color backdrop, light, dark, dark, light, and then you can create explosions. So I went out when I made these images to my, just like outside my house, and I set up my little backdrop and I would just throw things. Flour, baby powder, set off smoke emitters, throw dead flowers, things like that. I loved it, so much fun. So if you're going to do something like this, try that. It's also important to note that each of these layers that we've been looking at, this is the smoke layer, have different blending modes. So we've got the lighten here for the smoke. So this layer is on blending mode lighten. And then down here, we've got an overlay, more lighten, darken. All different types of ways of blending things. So if you're not sure how to get this thing, the salt that you photographed, into the image, cut it out, paste it in, and then try different blending modes to see what works. It always surprises me what works. So back to finishing up this image. adding in the texture, which really helped create that sense of chaos, brightening it in certain places, darkening it in others. And you see this saturation layer here, like really pumping up the saturation in the background. I think that's great. I think that, you know, if you have this sense that you shouldn't do something because it's not how people are supposed to do it within your craft, just do it. Just try. See how it looks. See if it motivates the picture or not. In this case, it did. It was really beautiful to have this much color in the image. And so I went for it. I wouldn't usually. I'm not someone who like pumps up the saturation in my images, but I did here and I love it. So I hope that you love this image. Let me know how you're feeling about these videos and if you're learning anything, if you're entertained. Thank you so much for watching. Bye guys.